How you going, everyone? Here we go. We got the Dad Rock Wayward. Yeah, I'm pretty wayward. Imperial Indian Pale Ale. Robbie's brought it around.
I was just going to read the side of it. See.
Have a read. It's 8%.
East meets West. 8%. With this hybrid Imperial IPA that combines truckloads of West Coast USA hops with an authentic Vermont IPA yeast strain.
Yum.
A hint of malty sweetness and a fat hop aromas. Hide the size of the beer with a smooth hop finish that fades slowly.
Oh, that's gorgeous. That's really nice. That's worth looking out for, that one. I tell you, that's a beauty.
Mm.
Where's that one, mate? Mmm.
Product of Australia, kidding.
You're kidding.
Kidding, mate.
Yeah.
The way that was the talk up, it was either going to be...
West Coast. I thought away we was in West Coast somewhere, in San Diego. Nah. That's gorgeous, isn't it? That's a beauty. Thanks, Robbie, for bringing that one
That's
around.
All right, mate.
That's a ripper.
One,
that's made my day.
I saw one beer there. I'm not sure if we had that one before. No, it was $37.
Oh,
for that size. We had
37.
That. Have we had that one?
Because
I saw the $230 or something. It was $210 for a six-pack.
Mm.
It was the big bottle one. I thought, have we had that one before, the $37 one? Does that ring a bell?
Nah.
I'm sure we didn't.
We've had a couple of real good ones, real expensive ones.
But not
$19, $20, but little bottles. Little bottles for $20.
Mm.
We paid big bucks.
You got all the big bottles of Chimay there too, in the big bottle size.
Yeah, Chimay's not one of my favourites.
No, but they've got the whole range of the big bottles coming.
Yeah, they go the big bottles. How much was that one?
Can't remember, mate.
15.
Something like that.
Yeah, it would be right up there. 8%. Big bot. Yeah. Have to be. And it's gorgeous.
18 or something, maybe.
Yeah, I'd say. Closer to 20 than 15, probably. So where they've made it... Oh, they've made it in Camperdown. You know Camperdown, don't you?
On the way to Sydney?
Nah, is it?
No.
I thought Camperdown was over near Geelong.
Probably is, I think, isn't it?
That was just a guess. I don't know every town in Melbourne or Victoria.
Camperdown.
Camperdown.
No, you're right. It's over that way somewhere.
Near Geelong somewhere. Well, what do you think? That's a lovely beer.
Nice night for it. No rain still. Still in
no rain, everyone. It's just powering here. Had a big day in the veggie garden.
Yeah.
You've had a big day too, Robbie. Been out in the farm doing all your crap. What were you up to today? Fences?
Doing a drop off the chicken wire, the different parts of the fence, doing some raking up a bit of acorns.
Wow.
A couple of hours of raking.
Well, I watched the show on YouTube today and it was about this Indian guy that just come out of the bush, and he was living off the land and hiding from all the white people. And he did it for years, and there was about, I don't know, 20 of them or something, but they all died off slowly, and he was the last one, and he come into town.
Mm.
And his thing that they survived on, acorn soup.
Really?
Yep. Acorn soup. And to get the acorns, they had to risk getting caught and shot by the whiteys. But they always got their acorns, and they had the acorn soup.
It's hard work picking them up.
Mm. Yeah. That was amazing.
I get the boys up in the competition at the moment.
Yeah, what's that one?
The bucket competition.
Who can get the most acorns?
Yeah, fill up the bucket first.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You got to do that shit, don't you? Yeah,
the $20 prize, and then now, because I won it, so it's gone up to $40 now. I've thrown it back into the tally, so tomorrow night we're doing the bucket challenge again. We're calling it the bucket challenge, the acorn bucket challenge. I'm going to dry it out though.
Cheers, mate. That's lovely.
Gonna dry them out a bit so they don't go mouldy.
Yeah, out in the sun today for a few hours yourself again.
Mm.
You got a bit of colour again, mate.
Yeah, bit of sun out there.
Yeah, I got a bit sunburnt. And I was all a bit red on the face.
It's good though, you need the vitamins.
Oh, it's all good for you. Plus I was...
You don't look very burnt though.
I was digging and chipping away with the mattock and chopping out the rocks and... that sleeper in and got it all sorted. I'm pretty happy with that, what I've got done.
Mm.
Now we've got the black gold.
The black gold.
So we're going to mix that in with the soil.
Mm.
and a bit more mulch.
Maybe get a bag of chicken manure too.
Yeah, I want chicken manure
get
in there.
Get some chicken manure into it and you'll be laughing.
Yeah, I did that before. I did the chicken manure before and the blood and bone when I first did the veggie garden, but I didn't realise those roots were there. Fuck. I chopped heaps of roots out today.
Yeah.
Probably 10 kilos of roots.
And you're just sucking it, man.
Oh, big inch and a half, big roots, with heaps of taps going out into all my veggie garden. I just got rid of them all. All right, fellas, that's a great beer. Oof. I'm going to be carried away with the bullshit now. The garden bullshit.